Sorry. Today I tried to share my experience with Apache Airflow, MySQL, Power BI. Yeah, created, built the AI pipeline with these tools. My name is Mykola Sidorok. I work as self more than 1 year as a senior big data engineer. About my experience, I work with different customers from different business areas, such as insurance, banking, social gaming, telecommunications, agriculture, and each of my projects, I work with different tools. And my several projects, I work with Apache Airflow, and these tools very like me for me. My each projects maybe yeah it's every my each projects I work with Power BI, and I also like these tools. Let's start it together again. What I want to tell you about what is Airflow. Some entity from Airflow, it's about XCOM, triggers, and operator and flow. Also, a few words about SQL chemistry, service principle, why we need this for automatically refresh our data sets as Power BI service via RASPI. And I show you a short demo about these solutions. And else, I want to share my experience with Power BI, how we can create Python scripts which will refresh all data sets in Power Query. And a little about PowerShell and the script is Power Query for create automatically data catalog. What is that Airflow? Airflow is a very flexible platform which help that help data engineer build their pipeline. It's a platform to programmatically author schedule and monitoring workflows. Airflow started in October 2014 as a solution to manage the company's incredible complex workflow. First release, it was in June 2015. The main features of Airflow is that Airflow is written in Python. You can use Python code when you describe your process in Airflow. It's give you many benefits for your organizations, your process in development. For example, you can organize it's what you like. Enter your account, specific or your infrastructures, or the size of teams, and maybe many others requirement. Airflow uses direct cycling graph. It's a short terminology DAX. It's manage workflow orchestrations. Task and dependency are defined in Python, and then Airflow manages the scheduling and execution. What else does can be run either on defined scheduler. This scheduler you can set up monthly, daily, hourly, what you want, and or basically on external event triggers. Also, Airflow task scheduler is built on Celery. What is Celery? Celery is a Python library that allow you to organize and quick plus asynchronous and distributed execution of your task. In mainly DAX is some semantic combinations of your task that you want to perform in strictly defined sequence on specific scheduler. And all your on Airflow site, all task I divider in pools. Pools are created manually, and as a rule, the purpose is to limit the load on working with the source or to type task within the DevH. Also, main principle in Airflow, it's dynamic, extensible, elegance, and scalable. Dynamic Airflow, it means that pipeline are configurations as code Python. and allow for dynamic pipeline generations. This allows to, for writing code the instances pipeline dynamically. Extensively, what does it mean? Easy defined your own operators, executors, and extend the library so that it fits the levels of abstraction that suit your environment. Elegance, Airflow pipeline are learned and explicit parameterizing your scripts is built into the core of Airflow using the powerful maybe Jinja templates and Jira. Of course, scalable, it's Airflow has modular architectures and uses a message cricket to orchestrations and arbitrary number of works. Airflow is ready to scale to infinity. What you think about, you can do this, whatever what you want to do, if you know Python, of course. Yeah, some entity in Airflow. XCOM is a mechanism that lets tasks talk to each other. As by default, tasks are entry installations and maybe running on entry different machine. For example, you need to send something data from one task to other task, and XCOM is this mechanism that let you do this. But it's only designed for small amount of data. Do not use them to pass some big data sets or large big around large value like data frame. Yeah, and XCOM are explicitly pushed and pulled from their storage using the XCOM pull push and XCOM pull method on task instance. There are also a lot of different triggers in Airflow. Its triggers help you to more flexible understanding how work previous task, and instead depending from their previous status, building new different scenario for your workflow. All operators have a trigger rules. This is argument which defines the rules by which the generate task get triggered. And the default value for trigger rules is all success. Also, you have write additional task status, all done, all fail, on fail, one success, and create some branch in this task after these triggers. Will be work on next branch for you set up in this task. What else about operators? Yeah, Airflow has a lot of different operators which help you help you create your workflow more flexible. Yeah, an operator is entity on the basis of which job instances are created, which describe what will happen during the executions of a job instance. For example, if you use bash operator, yes, this operator help you running some bash script. Python operator help you running bash script. Oracle operator help you work with Oracle base. And there are a lot of different operators, and it's very convenient for Airflow. Okay, let's speak about SQL chemistry. SQL chemistry is a Python SQL toolkit and object relational Muppet, ORM, shortly. That give application development a full, powerful, flexible SQL. You can write SQL syntax scripts with power or with Python scripts, and it was easy. It provided a full suite and of well-known enterprise level persist pattern designed of for efficiency and high performing database success, adapted into a simple and Python domain language. Firstly, SQL chemistry was released in February 2006 and quickly became it of the most widely used library in Python community for object-oriented mapping. This technology allows you to compare model whose types are incompatible. For example, you can that you have a database table and program language objects. In other words, you can access class objects to manage data in database tables. You can also create, modify, delete, filter, inherit class objects, map it all database table, which significantly reduce the filling of the code base. It's a short about SQL Alchemy. Okay, service principle. What we need to service principle? Service principle let you do something with your applications without users. It's creating an Azure Active Directory app registrations, and you create within your tenant to perform unattended resource and service level operations. What else? Before using service principle in Power BI, for example, in my demo, you need to give full access for your service principle to workspace and all necessary permissions as a member or admin. Okay. Oh, demo. Yeah. First demo, I want to show you how work Apache Airflow. I take this solution from different my projects, and I try to show you how it's work. What I will do here, I take data via REST API, check last date from this REST API from MySQL, and upload this data to MySQL. After that, I will refresh if all success. I refresh first datasets with Power BI, and after that, when datasets one will be refreshed, I refresh second datasets. But before Airflow will be generate token access for this Power BI REST API code. Okay, let's get started. Now I show you DB, create a demo service DB. Yeah, now we haven't any table here. App registrations, I create in Azure, Microsoft Azure demo service principle when I take him permission, give permissions with Power BI service. We have full permission for read and write to this dataset, data flow, any entity in Power BI. Any component in Power BI. Also, I create two data sets. Demo provider now is empty. Yeah. Load your report. Yeah, it's empty. First data set connect to MySQL, get data from MySQL. Next, we connect to analysis service, this data set from demo Power BI, and get first 10 row from analysis service. And if it also empty. Yeah, blank. Okay, let's run in Airflow. Before we need to create our table with SQL Alchemy, create a short script for this, connect to Azure database and create table name provider with all column what we need for this. Yes, running, wait when script completed, commit. Yes, if now we go to our database, refresh, reconnect, and now we can see that provider table was created successfully with all column what we need. After that, we run in our DAG for from terminal. Yeah. Airflow. Wait, when it's on, it'll be running. It's no more than 1 minute, okay. Go to localhost. And now we can see ETL client demo. Yeah, here we can see our graph. It's our Airflow with all tasks. Oh, yeah, it's you can see code here, but also you can see code here in the UA, and this you can find all full code writing on Python. Yeah, first we import our lib, connect to our database with config credentials, create scheduler interval, start date when it started, and create some Python function. And after that, we create a task for this for our Airflow. First task is we get provider data from from MySQL. Yeah, we create sessions and connect to this via SQL chemistry. It's get max, it's select from look like from select max processing date from table provider. Now our table empty, and that's why it will be null, and that's our data provider data upload to MySQL. And each step we describe, we create task for this. This trigger rule, for example, yes, if our date exists, or we connect to MySQL database and successfully, we go next task. But if failed, we created alert. Yeah, I create additional Python script for alert, and I receive a mail on without this error. It's every task have task ID, and it's dependent from, for example, the bash operator. We use this alert running with bash command. We running our Python code, and this code sends this alert. Let's get started and running our code. What happened? I don't know. Yeah, we wait when it will be green color. Your current and running.
Doesn't matter if you switch out the refresh in the middle of the screen on the right.
Oh, sorry.
There was in the middle of the screen auto refresh a button or switch.
reach. Oh,
yeah,
sorry.
On the left. Yeah, doesn't matter or not?
Oh, okay. Yeah. Sorry. thank you. And now first task checks. After that, we get max.providers. It's if we see our log, yeah, we can see which it's not, it's empty because we haven't any data on our, and we load data to DB. If you open our table, yeah, now we can see that some data in upload to our table. Yeah, show here. After that, now it's generate access token, and we click by log, we can see that's our access token generate here, is com, and send you our next task. Now it's only delayed, and send in refresh provider data. We wait when delay Python task will be finished. And after that, we refresh our first data set. What else? You can rerun your previous step. For example, yes, if you need to rerun some Airflow DAG before, you can choose this process here and click rerun again. What else? Gantt diagram. It's also, you can see how long your task running. Full code, yes, and delay Python task. If something happens with connections, this step will be skipped, and this step get max provider data fails, and this receive alert about this error. Yeah. Oh, our first data sets was refreshes, and now if we click here, we can see, yes, demo provider. Oh, yeah, it's today was refreshed. Now we wait when second our data sets will be refreshed.
Just one question. Can Airflow invoke bash scripts on the different server? For example, you have a cluster and you're running job bash scripts on the different servers. Is it possible here?
Yes, Airflow lets to do this. You need only correct setup in your config file with this credential.
Thanks. Like one more question. So you have like error handlers for first two actions, but if, for example, this delay Python task data will fail, the pipeline stops or not?
Oh, not pipeline to finish, but you can set up alert, and you can create additional alert for this for each step, and each task will have error. We will receive email.
Yeah, but in case of error, a pipeline is stopped. It's and it will not go to the next step if there is no this fork.
If something with task ID is will be created not correct, yes.
Okay. It's only a matter of the alerts. If you would like to receive them, then you can make all these conditions.
Sorry. What do you mean?
But only if we would like to get an alert about the failure, then
we can stop our MySQL database and see how work. Yeah, our workflow stopped.
I have a question about the fork and the error handling. If one of the fork fails, the overall pipeline fails, or can you configure it somehow?
If
we look at the fork that you have, the parallel execution at some point, and if one of the parallel executions fails and
you can set up triggers rule. Yes, this trigger rules. It will be check your all process, and if all success, it will be good. It's so one of failed. You can also create task ID with alert and receive email about this, about which process will be error. Was error, cage error, sorry.
And then if you would like to retry the duck, it would start from the beginning.
You can if now we start of beginning here, we will be have that provider data success. We can do this. In this case, load data not to be load to your DB. For example, let's check error count now. Oh, sorry. Oh, for example. Rough count, we have 15,000. If we rerun, wait, load data to DB. Finish, it's very quickly. And if we selling data from provider. Only, maybe refresh. It's the same count. Okay, our data set first was refreshes, and the second data refresh also was refreshes. Go to reports, and you can see some information about these data sets. And also check here. Yeah, our data upload here too from analysis service. Also I want to show you how we can on my projects. Yeah, it was great big red button for customer, and this button help customer refresh all data sets in their workspace. How I realized that? I realized it's, of course, other way. It was data flow with Power BI, but also I find a way how we can do this with Python code. Oh, sorry. Down Power BI refresh. Yeah, it's... go to our query. Click by source. And here you can see it's the same Python script code that help you to generate access token. Credentials I drop after our meeting, of course. You can hide your credentials in your environment and call your variable from your environment. And in this case here, we go to Power Query where we generate Python script. Before you need to install OI library in your environment. Also, and after generate access, you go via REST API, get all information about your dataset, your dataset ID, and after that, create cycle which will refresh its each dataset in your workspaces. And after that, of course, you need to create data frame because without this data frame, Power Query can't create. Will be error in Power Query. Okay, it's start at refresh, and when we refresh these data sets, next refreshes will also be refreshed. A few seconds and our data sets also started refreshing. And else interesting solution, how we can, for example, in one project, we created a data catalog from Power BI. We created different REST API calls, get metadata from data flow and data sets, but some metadata from data sets can get via REST API. For example, table name, entity, column name, their data types. And in this case, we can connect to analysis service and get this data, get this metadata from analysis service with a similar SQL script. Yeah, for this solution, we can use RScript, PowerShell, also generate access token via service principle and connect to our analysis service. And it's script. Oh, yeah, unfortunately, I'm not created generate access token automatically. Sorry. But you can, we can also create this automatically without input every time our code. Yeah, it's provider data catalog. Yeah. Yeah, now to you can workspace data sets, all table, and all column. Also, you can get more information from analysis service, such as data type for each column, Power Query script, DAG script, and it look like next. Your executed R script, and R script via PowerShell generate access token and connect to MS OLAP and get this information what you need. Yes, and it look like here. I'm finished. Yeah.